there anything else you could have done today? Because it looks really like you did everything right, but it was just one rider stronger.
Yeah, I think that's the right conclusion you can make today. I felt really strong. I think I did one of my best performances in the Ronde, but yeah, today was on a different level today.
When he went, you knew it was over, or you still had a bit of hope? We talk a lot about the headwind in the final.
Oh, I tried to just ride my own pace, and I still had some hope that maybe I could come back, but he was really strong. He could keep the gap as well, and I think he deserves to win here.
So what was going on at the start today? A little bit of inattention, crosswinds, what happened there?
Well, I like to be at the back, relaxing a bit. I didn't really think that there were going to be some breaks in the bunch, but all of a sudden the bunch was splitted. But my team did an amazing job bringing me back today a couple times, saving the situation. So yeah, I have to thank them.
Your legs are there, you're strong. What do you take away from this race though? Is there anything you could do differently that you apply in Paris-Roubaix or the next big races?
Well, I don't know. I'm actually quite proud on how I raced today. I think I did maybe a decisive move for the race on the Kruisberg. So I've never felt so strong that I could attack there. So the problem is there was Pogacar today that was even stronger.
What did you tell Tadej when he came across the line? He seemed to talk a bit there after the finish.
Yeah, I have a really good relationship with him. So. Yeah, I mean, it's phenomenal what he does here. I don't know if there's a lot of Tour de France winners that won the Ronde yet in the past, but yeah, for sure what he did today is really special. And I already knew from last year and from Edry Press that he's, yeah, Quaremont, he's so strong, and yeah, we saw that today again.
Las palabras de este corredor, el monstruo Mathieu Van Der Poel, que quedó en segundo lugar por detrás de Tadej Pogacar. Pero vamos a echarle un ojito también. Aquí le tenemos el resultado final de este Tour de Flanders 2023. Ahí lo podemos apreciar a un Tadej Pogacar. Un Tadej Pogacar ganador, campeón, pedaleó 6 horas, 12 minutos y 7 segundos. En la segunda casilla entró, como dijimos, Mathieu Van Der Poel a 16 segundos. El tercer lugar fue Mark Pedersen, que le ganó en el golpe de riñón a Wout Van Aert. A 1:12 entraron. Wout Van Aert salió, no estuvo en el podio porque fue cuarto. Y quinto, Powens, también a 1:22. Así que esta vez no pudo ser el podio, el tridente. Pogacar, Van Der Poel, Wout Van Aert, no se dio ese tridente en el podio. Porque bueno, Mark Pedersen fue más rápido en ese remate. Un remate donde venía un pelotoncito más o menos. Traía bastantes corredores. Ahí venían Mark Pedersen y Wout Van Aert, porque Tadej Pogacar venía en solitario y en persecución de Tadej Pogacar venía Mathieu Van Der Poel. Y ya después sí, el grupito ese que les comentábamos, un grupito ahí numeroso más o menos, ahí fue donde el más veloz fue Mark Pedersen, que le ganó a Wout Van Aert en la raya ya con el golpe de riñón. Bueno, esas fueron las declaraciones, las impresiones de este corredor, monstruo, bestia, de Mathieu Van Der Poel.